I think I have vine borers in my squash. Can I control them with insecticides? And that's almost a standard question now, Mr. D.
Yeah.
You know, when you grow squash, it's like, wait a minute, my plant has collapsed. What happened? So it's the old vine borer. So can you control it with insecticides?
No. You can't control it with insecticides, but you can prevent it from happening. And this is another one, like I mentioned, most of the time with insecticide, we stay waiting until you have a problem, mm-hmm. identify the pest and treat it. But this is kind of like the fruit trees.
Oh boy.
You need to go with a preventative treatment. And there are several products if you treat them. Again, I'm reading from the Red Book.
Okay.
From the Red Book. It's got Carbaryl, bifenthrin, Zeta-cypermethrin, esfenvalerate, and permethrin and spinosad are all listed to prevent squash vine borer. But it's basically, you need to direct your sprays at the base of the plant.
Okay.
You don't have to spray the entire plant, and repeat applications up to 6 times, but not more than once every 7 days. So I would spray 6 times, spray once, wait 7, and just keep on doing it to get all of those applications in. And that's with the Carbaryl. The bifenthrin doesn't have, and the pyrethrin that I mentioned, bifenthrin, Zeta-cypermethrin, esfenvalerate, permethrin, and even the spinosad, well, there are different limits depending upon which product you're using. Some just say wait at least 7 days between each application, and they don't give you a limit to the number of applications you can make. The permethrin says do not apply more than 8 times per season, but it doesn't say wait at least 7 days between applications. And spinosad, maximum of 6 applications per season, and then wait 5 days before reapplying, 5-day intervals.